a lot of people think that breath holds are bad for us. However, when we do a breath hold or a series of them, we can get into a hypoxic state. And hypoxic training has been used by many athletes to enhance performance. In this video, I would like to draw the line in regards to when hypoxia is dangerous and when it is beneficial. I will share three reasons why hypoxia can be good for us. I will also share at the end of the video a quirky fact in regards to hypoxic living. I am a yoga teacher and a Buteyko method instructor. In yoga, we use breath holds called kumbhaka as part of the pranayama practice. And in the Buteyko method, breath holds are also used to enhance respiratory capacity. Hypoxic training is an umbrella term for any type of training that brings the saturation of oxygen below 91%. The way to monitor the saturation of your oxygen is by using an oximeter. Oximeters are small devices like this, which report one, your pulse rate, and second, the saturation of oxygen in your blood. When the saturation goes below 91%, you have simulated approximately an altitude of 200 meters of altitude. The saturation of oxygen under normal circumstances will be between 95 and 100%. If you see here, I am now at 97. If you have cold extremities, I suggest you rub your finger because maybe the circulation is not good. And those of you that have pained nails, you may want to make sure that the sensor is on the surface of the finger below the nail. High altitude simulation became quite popular after the Olympics of Mexico in 1968. Mexico City is at an altitude quite far over the sea level, and during these Olympics, quite a few athletes found that their performance was enhanced. This raised the interest of their coaches, which they found that the fact that they were training at a high altitude was part of the reason why their performance was enhanced. Prior to the Olympics of Mexico, Emil Zátopek, a long distance runner from Czech Republic, had used breath holds, or if you want to call it high altitude simulation training, for his preparation. In the recent years, Patrick McCone and his system Oxygen Advantage has raised a lot of awareness about high altitude simulation training. The exercise that Patrick has developed can allow an athlete to improve gradually his performance by using breath holds or simulating a high altitude environment at sea level. High altitude simulation is of course very different from involuntary breath holds or obstructive sleeping apnea, a condition which the person sleeping gets into a hypoxic state because he or she is not breathing. This is very beautifully demonstrated in a paper from 2014 titled Therapeutic Potential of Intermittent Hypoxia, a Matter of Dose. As you can see in the graph, in the upper left quadrant, there are a series of pathological conditions that are associated with breath holds. The conditions are high blood pressure, sympathetic activation, atherosclerosis, hypertension. In the lower right quadrant, you can see that hypoxic training has been shown to improve symptoms of depression, promote weight loss, suppress inflammation, enhance memory, and improve exercise tolerance. The key difference between the two groups of conditions or activities is that in the ones that belong to the upper left quadrant are done involuntarily, and they are associated with a sympathetic dominant of the nervous system. On the other hand, the ones that are in the lower left quadrant involve breath holds only a couple of times during the day. I will now share with you three reasons why hypoxic training can be beneficial for us. The first one is the most popular one. A lot of people are aware that a hypoxic state increases the number of red blood cells in the body. When we are practicing breath holds, after 3 to 5 repetitions, the spleen starts contracting, releasing some of its reserves of red blood cells. When we have more red blood cells in our body, we can accommodate more oxygen to be circulated around. The second one is the most logical one. Breath holds, or hypoxia, act as a stressor for the body. And as a result, it has been shown to upregulate the immune system. But the third one is, in my opinion, the most fascinating one. Breath holds have been shown to increase the uptake of blood glucose by the cells without the involvement of insulin. This is amazing because, with the exception of hypoxia, it is only exercise, the only other activity that allows that to happen. This is, of course, is very important for people with diabetes, but in reality, anyone that wants to increase his or her insulin sensitivity. The fun fact I promise to share with you is that people living in a high altitude where the saturation of oxygen is low have been shown to be healthier. In Peru, they have been shown to have a lower level of obesity. In the United States, the occurrence of diabetes has been shown to be lower in people living in a high altitude. I hope by now you are convinced that breath holds or hypoxia is not necessarily dangerous, provided that they are done voluntarily. I would like to know if you practice hypoxic training, whether it is through free diving, high altitude training, or just breath holds at sea level. If you enjoyed this video, you can like and subscribe to the channel, as I will be sharing more videos like this in the near future.